Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced course. In today's lecture, we will talk about route parameters. First, let's see what are route parameters. Route parameters refer to the dynamic parts of a URL that can change. They are typically used to pass data from one page to another within a web application. There are two types of route parameters. One is required parameter and second is optional parameter. Now, what are the required parameters? Required parameters in Angular are essential values in a route's path. They allow us to create dynamic routes by specifying unique values in the URL. For example, here we have /viewStudent/ID, where ID is crucial to fetch and display the correct data. For passing required parameter, first I'm going to update my route. First we will see the app routing module, and in this module I'm going to update my path and going to append this path with the required parameter, which is ID. Now, main purpose of our required parameter is we can fetch our data dynamically on the basis of this required parameter. Now let's update our viewStudent component for the sake of implementation of our required parameter. And here for fetching the route, first we need to use our built-in module ActivatedRoute. And I will use this route variable to fetch the params. So in ng-onInit, we will write this.route.params and we will subscribe it. And then get our params. First, I need a variable here and I'm gonna define it a route ID and its type will be any. And in this route ID, I will get the value of ID of my required parameter like this. Now let's display it on the front end. So that we can see the dynamic values of ID every time. Now let's run the application. Let's give our route path, which is viewStudent/ID. Here I'm going to pass ID 2. Now I'm going to pass the value 3 to my required parameter. And it fetches the student accordingly. And this is the way we can define our required parameters. Next, we have optional parameters. These are not essential for the application to run, but they provide additional useful information. You can pass optional parameters in query string. Now let's see how we can define our optional parameters in our application. For optional parameter, we don't need to change our route path because they are not defined on the route. We just only need to update our component. Again, we will use our activated route variable this.route.curyparams. Now for optional parameters, we will use curyparams and we will subscribe it. And then from the param dictionary, we will save our name value in this name variable. Then in our if condition, we will check if our name is defined. It will save the value of name in our route name variable. Let's again display this name variable on the front end just for the sake of testing purpose. But this ID will be required and name will be optional. Now you only need to focus on this route. How I'm going to change it? If I am not going to pass this required parameter, it's not loading my component. But if I'm not passing this optional parameter, it's loading the component but it's not showing our optional parameter. So required route parameters are set as part of the path, while optional route parameters are added as part of the web address when we transition from one route to another, and these are optional. Next, if we talk about the benefits of routing parameters, then first we have dynamic routing. Route parameters allow us to create dynamic routes in the application. Second is data fetching. They can be used to fetch specific data based on the parameter value. Third is user-friendly URLs. Route parameters help in creating meaningful and user-friendly URLs. Fourth is state management. They can be used to manage the state of the application without relying on external state management libraries. And fifth is improved navigation. With route parameters, we can navigate to specific components based on user actions or events. Hope you understand it. If you have any question or query, you can ask in comments. But if this lecture is helpful for you, then guys, please like, subscribe and share my channel. Thanks for watching.